All right, good evening. This is Bill Bostic, your sports reporter for Lingolstown Gazette. I'm visiting tonight with number 14, Nick Chimenti Jr., a defensive back and wide receiver. He's a sophomore this year. We're going to talk to him about the upcoming Chambersburg game against the Trojans down in Chambersburg on Friday. Kickoff is at 7 o'clock, and Lingolstown Gazette will have a reporter on the sidelines, Joe Gilloway. And before we talk to Nick, I also want to recognize our sponsors, Lingolstown Firehouse Bar, the soon-to-be not best-kept secret in the village of Lingolstown, and also Econ Wealth Financial Services on Lingolstown Road. They can help you get your finances in order, prepare for retirement, or whatever your long-term savings may be. So, Nick, we came up against some tough competition last week with the Harrisburg Cougars. But I think you had a pretty good game. You said earlier when I talked to you preparing for this interview that you had, what, 4 out of 5 game as far as 4 stars out of 5. Why do you have that at your own analysis? It's such a good game.
I didn't play perfect. I missed a few tackles, but as a team on defense, second half we played pretty solid. And yeah.
Well, in the second half, they didn't score. They scored a few points, if any, right?
They scored, I think, 8 points.
8 points, and they scored quite a few in the first half. So, yeah. What did you tighten up in the second half? Yourself, what did you do differently that may have helped out?
I got a better understanding of their offensive game plan.
Okay.
Their screens, their formations, and everything.
Yeah. Okay, so you sort of live and learn type of thing.
Yeah.
And then you had quite a good hit apparently on Butts, one of the Division I players. How did that play take place that you were able to get a good hit on him?
They ran a screen play and I was unblocked, so I came up and I made the play.
Okay. Yeah, apparently you got some of that 15 minutes of fame we get in life. You got with a picture that was in the Patriot News, Penn Live type of thing. So congrats on that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, looking ahead, what kind of challenges do you think Chambersburg's going to present the team? And we'll stick with defense this evening when we talk with you. What do you think they're going to present to you that may be challenging?
They have a spread formation, and they have a quick running back who likes to get to the outside a lot of times.
Okay.
And in the passing game, the quarterback, he's a big guy. He's 6'7", 6'6", and he's a pretty good arm. He can throw just about anywhere.
Yeah, he's going to be seeing over you guys, I would say, at 6'7".
Yeah.
Last thing on football, as a sophomore, my understanding is you put quite a bit of work in during the offseason. What did that involve that really has gotten you in a position as a sophomore to get quite a bit of playing time?
I had a lot of workouts over the summer with some college players from Lock Haven, and we did a lot of speed work, agility work, and just all-around defensive and offensive work. And with Denny, right after basketball season.
One of the coaches here. Okay.
He does workouts with the team and speed and agility, and you work out with him. I worked out with him since after the last basketball season all the way through this football season.
Okay. And what have you seen as far as improved speed and agility? Have you seen an improvement, a noticeable improvement?
Yeah, last year I ran like a 5-second 40.
Okay.
And this year I came up to a 4.72.
All right, that's a pretty significant drop. Okay,
yeah.
Great. Lastly, are you gearing up to go to college after 2 more years of school?
Yeah, I'm trying to keep my grades up right now. So if colleges do look at me, they don't turn away because I have bad grades, a bad average.
Yeah, that's always, we're in high school, you're students, you got to excel in the classroom as well. And I think the coaches try and push you in that direction as well.
Yeah.
It's not just all about football. Well, I want to congratulate you in that you're getting significant playing time as a sophomore because we're going to have more seniors graduate this year. We're going to need leaders to come up, and it sounds like you're putting yourself on a track to be one of the leaders next year as a junior. When you say?
Yeah, we have a lot of juniors too.
Okay.
We have a lot of good leaders coming back next year.
That's good to hear. I mean, this year, we've been close in every game. We've had 3 losses. We were in those other two. The only one we had difficulty was with Harrisburg. And so we're playing well, and I think we still have a real good shot at the playoffs. And you have time to improve. I mean, this squad has time to improve and to see what you can do at the balance, at the end of the season.
Yeah.
Okay, good luck the rest of the way. Good luck on Friday night. Let's see if we can get a W.
All right, thank you.